such a fitting thing for him. He loved what he did. I think he lived his profession. Those are the memories that I have of him. Never turning anybody away from his door, any patient, any time of the day. You just get up and see him. I can't forget that.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Prashant. Thank you so much, Anuradha.
As you said, I'm pretending to be working hard. Actually, I'm not. But today is a very special day for us. And let me share with you from 50 plus years ago, my most vivid memories of my father are of him in a clinic treating the indigent in remote villages of India. And my mom was a beneficiary of some interesting payments he received for his service. Tomatoes, peanuts, rice, whatever the villagers grew in their farms and could afford to spare. My mom was comfortable with barter because she comes from a massive rural joint family where sharing is taught every few hours in every action at home. We children learned giving from her. Anuradha's first memories of my dad include watching patients line up outside our house in Machilipatnam at ungodly hours, asking, "Doctor gar unnara?" Which is the doctor available? And being shocked to see him wake up from tired slumber to see them again. One of those midnight patients was an infant girl, Bhargavi Maglui, who's on the call here today. Her better eyesight helped her pick a great husband in my sister's son while at UMass. 20 plus years ago, Anuradha and I met Dr. G.N. Rao, whose life story from Rochester, New York to Hyderabad in establishing an eye research startup is an inspiration for entrepreneurs, especially social entrepreneurs. I remember being moved by his commitment, purpose, and intelligence. I had little doubt that L.V. Prasad Eye Institute would be one of the finest ophthalmic research centers in the world under his leadership. It is now. And I'm so glad to see you here again, Dr. Rao. You haven't aged, sir. Now, 10 plus years ago, relatively recently, Anuradha and I met Ram and Revati Raju. They are our community's pride. Boston loves Vision Aid. While ours might be their first investment in research, our other dear friends, the Guptas, Ram and Minu, Sharmas, Vandana and Vivek, Srinivasans, Pratima and Venkat, and others, they invest in Vision Aid because of their confidence in the Rajus and their execution efficiency. So you see, these three different life stories, circles from 50 years ago, 20 years ago, and 10 years ago, they had to intersect. That is called Nizam in Arabic. And here we are, Nizam. Happily, affordable technologies for the visually impaired will be a reality soon. I'd like to give a shout out to my mom, Vasanta, who is here, my sisters, Sangeeta and Punita, and Punita's husband, Prasad, as are three of my dad's four living siblings, Madhusudan from India, Ram Gopal from California, and Suresh from Denver. Anuradha, Sangeeta, and I are grateful to our sister, Punita, for managing the foundation's work. She does the hard work, I get to make speeches. I'd like Ram Gopal uncle and Suresh uncle to say a few words. Though they look a lot younger than I do, it is true that they knew my dad long before I did, by at least a decade. Thank you, Vision Aid and L.V. Prasad Eye Institute, for all you're doing to mankind. It's our pleasure to be here today.
Of the three, I'm so honored and really so happy that you're actually organizing this event in the name of my father and mother. And I really miss my father. It has been really 5 years since we lost him. But today I feel like he's actually not gone anywhere. He's there. He's actually there treating those patients at L.V. Prasad Eye Institute, you know. That's how I feel. I'm really touched by whatever you do, Revati and Ram. I'm really proud of what you do as the part of the Vision Aid. And thank you so much, family, for being here for us today. And then also, I want to really appreciate Prashant and Juju for their generosity and making this happen, and trying to see through what my dad would have liked to see, and then really executing on that. And really, somebody has to really take that part and then really continue on. And then actually, thank you to Prashant, Juju, for continuing that legacy. There's really, you know, not much I can say, because everybody has already touched upon what my dad really liked, what his passion was. My dad's first passion was his patients. Second was his hospital. Third was his surgeries. So he was just always. But one thing I can say is that even he was busy with his profession, he always had time for his wife and his kids and family, always. So there were days when he would come back from his clinic at 10 p.m. and he would sit with us till 2 a.m. to make sure we all got our algebra right, math right, science right. He would make sure all of our homework was done. So that's the kind of a father we had, and that's the kind of a, my mother cannot speak much now, but he was a very, very loving husband as well. So thank you so much for everybody, and I cannot, Punita, you take it away.